This video tracks my tribe's progress over the first 50 days on our new server, ASA Kingdom.
Sunshine, lollipops and rainbows, everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. Brighter than a lucky penny when you're near.
He's just flying right above my head.
Hitting him! Yeah, go on, go, go, go!
Good, just
he should have kept some.
Yes,
yes!
Let's go! After the Pteranodon tame, we headed back down to base, made some high gear and built some infrastructure.
Not gonna
I tamed a moss drops, went on a killing spree.
Ah,
yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna be tamed.
Then we set out to look for our permanent base location. Since this server is PvP, we searched around the map for small rat holes or caves which would be easy to hide in and defend. Eventually, we decided on this mushroom cave situated outside the swamp. I set up a simple foundation while Daniel tried to set a water system up leading to the cave. Eventually, he got picked off his bird by a capro, which led to a massive mess.
Oh, I'm being attacked!
I'm coming, bird! What? It's all the way through here! No!
I can't get off. Drop me, drop me, drop me. Oh, there's a snake killing it! Yes! Go, snake!
Oh my god, Daniel, I need your help! Daniel!
Alright, run, run! I'm taking the file!
It's got me! Daniel.
I can't get on it, it's too high up!
Since all of our pteranodons had died and Daniel had logged off, I made some backup stuff and got my gear after dying a few more times. I had to run all the way across half the map to where we used to live just to get some safety. On the morning of day 3, I tamed a pego by accident and found a level 75 pteranodon which I knocked out and tamed. I used my old PT saddle on him to go and get some cementing paste from Beaver Dam before heading home to work on the base more by finally setting up that water line that caused this whole mess. I knocked out a high level pteranodon that got eaten while I wasn't there. I quickly tamed a berry collector near base and then walked it into base. I picked up Luke, my new tribe mate.
Oh my god, Luke. Look at me. Good.
And then headed down towards the red orb to tame another pteranodon for Daniel before logging off for the night. I logged back on day 9 to extend the base. I bred the pteranodons collect 3 eggs. While the eggs were incubating, I went on a meat and metal run in order to build a trough and fill it with meat. Daniel hopped on and I showed him all of my progress.
Yeah.
We dealt with a problem with snakes at our front door and I grinded some narcotics on the berry collector. The pteranodons hatched, so I named them and we went on a mini metal run with our pteranodons. I got killed by a snake and made a forge to burn the metal in and made a smithy as well as some metal gear. We grinded to make some wooden dino gates for an RG trap and a mini base for the redwoods. After we imprinted the PTs and got flat gear, we headed over to the redwoods to tame some RGs. We set up the RG trap and mini base. I found a level 140 RG, so I led it into the trap while Daniel waited to trap it.
Yeah, I'm really bringing him. All right, prepare yourself, then.
I see him.
Is he still following me?
Yeah, he's following you. Keep running.
It's a straight line. It's a straight line.
No!
Why is the bird passive mode at all? For a stupid bird.
After we knocked out the RG, I stole and killed a baby Patchy for Prime.
Oh my god, Daniel, I've picked up the baby Patchy.
Oh my god.
And we got...
The RG tamed at level 209 and we got attacked by a level 115 RG, which would be perfect for breeding.
115!
Oh my god, it's a level 115!
So we knocked it out and used the leftover prime to tame it while we almost froze to death. Once the RG tamed, we flew them home, filled up the trough and logged off. Me, Luke and Daniel were back on at day 13, after Luke got killed by a raptor.
Ryan, there's raptors in our base.
In our base.
Yep,
and we bred the RGs. But we realized we couldn't hatch the egg without aircon. Me and Daniel went out searching for our Anki for way too long and eventually found one on Herbivore Island, on the other side of the map. We found a level 145 Stego, but we didn't have enough Tranks to tame it, so we killed him and claimed his child. The Anki tamed, so we cryed the Stego and flew home. Luke upgraded the base to stone and we realized how massive he was. We built some more forges, Luke killed my Pego and
hey, Pego friend.
Don't claim it. I just got rid of it.
And we worked on the base a bit. Me and Daniel headed up to the snow to collect some oil and polymer by mass murdering some penguins, and I almost died in some freezing cold lake while trying to get silica pearls.
What do you need me to do?
Daniel, pick me up! We got some jobs and flew home to use the materials to build a fabricator, some gasoline, and a generator. I got some beaver dams and Daniel tamed a dodo, which we named after John from my other 100 day series on single player. That John died on day 50, so we'll see how long this one lasts. By now the baby PDs are grown up, so we played catch with the new John, repaired our armor, and put John on his own special spot on a mushroom. Anyway, after that we regrouped and logged off for the night. Since the server is always running, sometimes days will go by without us being on. Anyway, the challenge which we gave ourselves was to complete one boss fight in 100 arc days, or about 2 real life weeks. We were back on day 36 to put in some serious work. We went on a massive metal run with the Argies in New Anki whilst talking to another tribe who joined the server while we weren't on. They were called the Tribe of Krem and were currently the only other people on our server other than us. We burnt the metal in the forges and went on a meat run. We made and placed a new fridge before playing with the modded cryopods and cryopod guns we made. We used the metal to make some long neck rifles, some trank darts, and a dino trap before heading out to tame some dinos. We went through the redwoods and ended up down in the snow, so we collected fur by killing some snow dinos for some fur gear. We tried to find silica pearls but failed again. We found a stone argy trap and water dino trap made by Krem.
They have a level 171 dolphin!
Before knocking out a decent level beaver near the beaches.
He's max health, I'm pretty. Oh, don't let him go down.
While the beaver was knocked out, we found a level 90 Rex, which we felt like taming just for some protection.
No! Nah, he might. Yeah, his oxygen's not going down. We'll
do it. After the Rex was knocked out, I flew down to pick up the beaver before waiting for the Rex to tame. Once he had tamed at level 134, I cryoed him and we flew back to the base to make some fur gear, saddle some dinos, and park up all the grown-up dinos. By now, the Stego and the 3 Pteranodons were finally fully grown.
Yeah.
We went drop hunting a bit and Daniel got a load of Ascendant stuff. I used a smelted metal to upgrade our gate to metal and build a little aircon room to incubate eggs in. I just needed to make some aircons to finish the room, so I gave it another shot at finding silica pearls and finally found some in this little lake outside of the snow. These are the coords if anyone is interested. I flew home and made the aircons to finish the aircon room and finally started incubating those Argy eggs. I logged off for the night while Daniel hatched the eggs and raised the Argies overnight for me. I was back on day 47 to see the fully grown up Argies and saddle them. I used the silica pearls and metal that we collected to build a vault to store all of our stuff and a turret as well as some bullets to defend the base. I made loads more cryopods and logged off. Daniel hopped on, so we went up to the snow for more silica pearls, oil, and organic polymer before breeding our new Argies to continue our line. I made me and Daniel pump shotties and bullets. We incubated and hatched the eggs and got a weight and health mutation in some twin Argies. We moved the Argies over to the trough and unfortunately had to kill one. After incubating the Argies, we found a low-level frog which we decided to knock out and tame for cementing paste at the swamp cave. However, when we got there, Krem had blocked it off, so we headed down to the Kaiden cave. While we were here, we decided we would go get the first artifact for the brew mother.
Daniel, pick ones, pick ones, pick ones!
Oh, 140.
After we left the cave, I collected some beaver dams, went home, and became an Ogg barber.
What would you like today?
Long taper, medium.
Coming right up.
Oh! Ryan, this is what I think of your haircut. No!
Daniel!
I extended the stone foundations and added some lights around the base. We on a metal and crystal run to make a chemistry bench before going on a drop run. Luke hopped on and we grinded a load more materials to add turrets and fill them with bullets. Me, Luke and Daniel went out to search for some good tames. Eventually we found a level 110 Rex in the redwoods, which we decided to tame.
Is he for me or you?
It's for you.
We realized the Rex also had a baby, so once he tamed, we claimed the baby and had a breeding pair of Rexes like that. We kept searching for good tames for a while, and I eventually found a level 145 UD in the snow biome, which was perfect. The UD scared me away with its ability, and I accidentally ran into a level 135 Rex, which distracted me. I began knocking him out, Luke and Daniel turned up to help me out.
He's running, guys, he's running.
Once Rex had knocked out, we searched around to find the UD and eventually found him down on the snow beach.
145, it's on me!
The UD was such a pain because it kept running around, but we doubled down and tried way too hard to knock it out.
He's scaring pigs. Oh, he's on me. Oh my god, I've just fallen through the iceberg! What just happened? Missed that, that was... Oh no. Oh no, he's there! This is crazy.
Daniel cried the Rex and the UD kept scaring our birds away, but eventually we knocked him out and somehow he didn't drown.
Oh no!
Oh my god, he just... He's not drowning, he's not drowning! Oh my god.
Once he was tamed, I cryoed him. I found a dog in the redwoods and headed home. I dropped the doe in the trap and we knocked him out. While it was taming, I made all the saddles and began raising the baby Rex. By now, the baby Argies had grown up, so we bred and incubated a load more eggs. Once the doe had tamed, we grinded some materials to extend the foundations in our baby raising area. We hatched all the Argy eggs and killed all the useless ones. I stayed up super late hatching eggs trying to get some cool Argy mutations and eventually got this dark orange and bright green Argies, which I was really happy with. Join ASA Kingdom in unofficial service for crossplay PvP. Subscribe and like for another video. Bye.